Welcome children to class 5. Today we shall study the second lesson of social studies. Before starting the lesson, I would like to ask a question. You plan to go out your family. What do you need to take with you? You would need a map. So let us we learn about map in this lesson. Lesson 2. Maps are guides. Children, this lesson we learn about maps, globe, advantages, disadvantages, types of maps, language of maps. Children, first we learn maps. Earliest maps made by the Babylonians in about 600 BC. The first map was created by Anaximander, a great philosopher, in the 6th century BC. The word map is derived from the Latin word mapu, which means napkin, cloth and seat. A map is a representation or a drawing of the earth's surface. Children, what is map? A map is a representation or a drawing of the earth's surface. Now tell me, how many of you have atlas at home? Have opened and listened it? You just turn the page, you can see different types of map on it. Some of these are as follows. A book of maps is called an atlas. What is an atlas? A book of maps is called an atlas. A person who studies and makes maps is called a cartographer. A person who studies and makes maps is called a cartographer. While the art of map making is called cartography. The art of map making is called cartography. What is a map? Do you know that if you cut the globe and flatten it, you get a map? You get a map. A map is the representation of earth on a flat surface, showing how things are related to each other by distance, direction and size. It can show a small neighborhood, a large city, a huge country, and even the entire earth. Next, we learn globes and maps. What is a globe? What is a globe? A globe is a small model of the earth. What is a map? A map is a drawing of the earth's surface. A map is a drawing of the earth's surface. We learn about differentiate between globe and map. Globe is a spherical device. Map is flat device. Globe is used to see whole world at a time. Map is used to see particular region and at a time. Globe is three-dimensional object. Map is two-dimensional object. Children, next we learn advantages of globe. Shape of land and water bodies are accurate. compass directions are correct, distance from one location to another is accurately represented. Next, advantages of maps. Can show details too small to be seen on a globe. Flag can be easily folded or carried. Children, next we learn disadvantages of globes. Cannot show small area in great detail. Not easily folded or carried. Next, disadvantages of maps. Size, shapes and relative location of a place may not be accurate, distorted. Children, what is map? A map is a drawing of the earth's surface. What is a globe? A globe is a small model of the earth. Advantages of globe. Shape of land and water bodies are accurate. What is an advantages of maps? Can show details too small to be seen on a globe. Children, let us we learn about types of maps. Maps are of several types. They are mainly classified into physical maps, political maps, thematic maps. First, we learn physical maps. Physical maps show natural features of the earth. Physical features like mountains, plateaus, rivers, lakes, oceans, etc. Different colors are used to show different features. For example, blue color is used to mark all kinds of water bodies. Children, what is physical maps? Physical maps show natural features of the earth. Physical maps very useful for mountaineers and pilots. Children, next we learn political maps. Political maps indicate states, national boundaries, capital and major cities. These maps show the cities, town and villages, countries and states of the world with their boundaries. Different symbols are used to mark the country capital and the state capitals. India is politically divided into 29 states and 7 union territories. Can you identify your state on the political map of India? Can you identify your state on political map of India? Yes, our state Tamil Nadu. Next we learn thematic maps. Maps that are made to represent particular information like the climate, roads, tourist place, etc. are called thematic map. Next we learn road maps. Road maps show highway and road, airport, railway tracks, cities and other landmarks of business. A road map or route map is a map that primarily display roads and transport links rather than natural geographical information. Road maps show major roads and highways that connect different cities. Road maps show major roads and highways that connect different cities. Road maps helps in giving people correct directions while driving. They also help people to plan their location. Help travelers to reach a particular place easily. Next, we learn climatic maps. Maps that give information about the climate, temperature, humidity, precipitation, rain and snow, etc. are region called climatic maps. Climatic maps give general information regarding the climate and rainfall of an area. Different colors used to show different climatic zone. Next, we learn language of a map. Distance, direction and symbols are used to show details on a map. These form the language of a map. First, direction in a map. The Chinese invented the compass rose. A compass rose is an instrument that shows directions. Ptolemy was an Egyptian geographer and map maker who was the first to show the direction north on a map by drawing the north line on top of the map. It shows us the four main directions on the map. Directions are cardinal points like north, south, east and west. The north is the top of the compass rose and the map. The south is the bottom. The east is the right hand side and west is the left hand side. These four main directions are called cardinal direction. Besides these cardinal directions, there are subdirections. Northeast lies between north and east. Northwest lies between north and west. Southeast lies between south and east. Southwest lies between south and west. Thus, a subdirection is midway between any two cardinal directions. Children, next we learn scale of a map. We measure distance in terms of scale. A scale is a ratio between the distance on the ground and the distance shown on the map. It is mentioned in the corner of the map. Example, the distance between your home and the temple is 20 kilometers. The distance between your home and the temple is 20 kilometers. You can show this distance in centimeter means cm. Take 1 centimeter is 10 kilometer. Then the distance between your home and temple is 2 centimeters. To measure large or like continents or countries on a paper, we use a small scale map. What is small scale map? To measure large or like continents or countries on a paper, we use a small scale map. To show a small or like your village to town on a paper, we use large scale map. Large scale map means show a small area like your village to town on a paper. The scale of map can also be diagrammatically zoned with the help of bar divided into equal division. Each division represents a fixed distance on the ground. This type of map scale is called a linear scale. All maps have a scale in one corner. All maps have a scale in one corner. The scale helps us to measure the actual distance between any two places. Children, next we learn symbols. The signs and the symbols that are used all over the world in different maps are called conventional symbols. A symbol is a shape or a sign that is used to represent something. Children, let us look at some of the commonly used symbols given. Color on a map. Maps use a color scheme that depicts different physical features on the earth, such as mountains, desert, oceans, etc. Blue denotes water bodies like oceans, seas, rivers, lakes. Light blue indicates shallow waters, whereas deep blue indicates deep water. Next, green. Green denotes plains or lowlands. Brown. Brown is used to show mountains and highlands. High mountains are indicated in dark brown. Low mountains and highlands are indicated in light brown. Children, next we learn key. Means map key or legend. A key is used in certain maps only. A key is used in certain maps only. It is explained what each symbol or colors on a map represents. The key of the map is also called the legend of the map. The key of the map is also called the legend of the map. Now, let us recall what we have learned in this chapter. Map. What is a map? A map is a drawing of the Earth's surface. We know about advantages and disadvantages of globe and maps. We know about types of maps. Maps are several types: physical maps, political maps, thematic maps. We'll know about language of map. Distance, direction, and symbols are used to show details on a map. Children, let us ask few questions. What is an atlas? A book of maps is called an atlas. What is a map? A map is a drawing of the Earth's surface. What does political map shows? Political map shows boundaries and countries. What does physical map shows? Physical map shows natural features of land. I hope enjoy this section. Thank you.